The Declaration of the Press Service of the Supreme Council of the Republic of Georgia. The necessity of the restoration, de facto, of the legal government of Georgia becomes more and more inevitable. That is most acutely evident to the occupational administration. Just for that reason, the participation of pseudo-intelligentsia hired by the junta has become frequent on TV and various mass media programs. The main topic of their talk shows is the so-called overcoming of political crisis in our country. It's also worth mentioning that the floor is given to ill-bred, degraded persons, permanently mentioning the name of the President of the Republic of Georgia, Zviad Gamsakhurdia, that is done deliberately and not by chance. By doing that, the spiritually filthy speakers, but not only spiritually, wish to disguise their political cunning and convincing weak arguments and lack of elementary knowledge of law. First of all, it concerns some former deputies of the Supreme Council of the Republic of Georgia. The restoration of the legal government is the prerogative of the government of the Republic of Georgia that should be made on the basis of the Constitution of the Republic of Georgia on the whole territory of the country. That's why the goal of the enemies of our state is to discredit this legal government with any possible method that is successfully carried out by mass media conducted by the occupational administration. It's also obvious that the scenario for renegade speech is plotted from the archives of the KGB ideological services. Out loud, often hysterical tone of their tirades is the symbiosis of the absolute lack of knowledge of law and being elementary ill-bred. Their speech contains the recipe for political so-called stabilization that is compiled according to the Cheka, OGPU, KGB and the many special services of other countries. These doomed pawns are eager to commit one thing. According to them, the Supreme Council of the Republic of Georgia at the earliest date should appoint and hold the elections in the state of being in power, de facto, the occupational administration in the country, and often and after that holding of the elections, so-called elections, should pass the power to the group of citizens, law violators, organized by junta, which is going to, inverted commas, win elections. It's curious, according to which law or the article they demand to do it. As for the factually occupied territories, they are absolutely omitted from their so-called election plans. Those slaves of junta permanently try to ram the idea that the legitimacy is a relative concept. They allude to the examples of medieval and even to earlier epoch, that one extremely barbarous, and don't remember that at the beginning of the 20th century, in order to legalize the norms of international law, the mankind founded the League of Nations, whose law successor is the present United Nations organization. Present Republic of Georgia is just the law successor of Democratic Republic of Georgia that was recognized with its territories of 91,000 square kilometers. The referendum held on March 31st, 1991, the population of Georgia voted for the restoration of the state independence of Georgia on the basis of 1918 May 26 Act of Independence. The returns of the referendum became the additional juridical and moral basis for the adoption by the Supreme Council of the Republic of Georgia of the 1991 April 9 Restoration Act of state independence, and an unanimous will of Georgian nation and the population of the Republic of Georgia was declared all over the world. Besides, they also forget that according to the law of the country, in case of president's death, the supreme legislative body and the government don't stop their functioning. That is much dreamed by the betrayers and their instigators. The constitutional mechanism of law succession is constant and should not be subjected to revision. Let us memorize the example of Lithuania and our emigration government of the Democratic Republic of Georgia, whose law successor are all the legal structures functioning today in Georgia. It's also worth mentioning that none of the PMs of the First Republic of Georgia were alive when, having based on the law of the chairman of the Supreme Council of Georgia, Sviat Gamsakhurdia, the head of the Supreme Legislative Body elected by Georgian nation, declared the restoration of the state independence, and the fact was recognized by all the legal governments of the world countries. But the renegades today are eager to conduct Stalin principles. If there is no man, there is no problem. But this will never come true. The Republic of Georgia is the immortal political body, and the restoration of the legal government of Georgia is the inevitable legal process, regardless anyone is against it or not. Nobody can lay obstacles to this process, just as to the process of revealing the betrayers and accompanying events. September 21st, 2011, Nanak Ahiani.